Hi, everyone. I'm Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse, founder and president of the Ruth Institute. And my colleague Don Fetter and I are here today to talk with you a little bit about what NBC News is doing to us and other pro-family organizations, people who have values just like yours. But before I do, I want to tell you what it means to be a hate group, because the Ruth Institute is a hate group. Here's what the Ruth Institute stands for. We believe that children need their own mothers and fathers. The children need their parents. They need to know their parents love them and love each other. And we also believe that traditional Christian sexual ethics protects those rights and interests of children better than all the competing alternatives out there. That's why we're against the sexual revolution. That's why we're in favor of traditional Christian sexual morality, because it protects the rights of children to have a lifelong loving relationship with both of their parents better than any of the alternatives. And that, you see, is what makes us a hate group. Because to say that parents have obligations to their children, this kind of obligation to your child's other parent, to say that, it places obligations on adults that a lot of adults in our world do not want to live up to. They resent those obligations. And so naturally, they hate us. And since they hate us, they call us a hate group. That seems to be the way it works. This is my colleague, Don Fetter. Don is the media coordinator and coalitions coordinator for the Ruth Institute. Don, say hi to everybody.
Hi, everybody. It's great to be with you, Dr. Morse. And this is obviously a very important issue, you know, being smeared by what used to be called the mainstream media.
Yes, yes. At NBC News, the reason we got so incensed about this is that NBC News has run not one, not two, but three hit pieces against pro-family organizations in the last 3 weeks running up to Christmas. And we think they're up to no good in doing that. You know, that's not an accident, right? So Don, tell people about the first one we discovered, or, you know, which one you find the most egregious, Don? Tell people what's going on with NBC News.
Oh, I don't know which is the most egregious, but the first one, let me see if I can recall the date. December the 11th, I believe.
December 9th. Starts December like 9th, this one. Like
yeah,
this one?
December. That's it. Yeah. December 9th. And this is NBC News, one of the major networks. This is the website of a newscast, and they said, basically, the message was, look at all of these hate groups that have participated in the Paycheck Protection Program. They've gotten millions and millions of dollars to be hateful. You know, we hate the fact that they're getting this money so that they can hate. Right. Of course, it didn't bother them that Planned Parenthood affiliates, the major providers and promoters of abortion in America, it didn't bother them, but they got millions of dollars.
That's right.
And I think, Dr. Morse, correct me if I'm mistaken, please. I think the Ruth Institute got a total of $30,000.
$37,000 to be precise. Yes, yes, yes. And all these groups combined, let's see, they got, what did they smear us with? The relief funds analyzed by NBC News were awarded a total of $4.3 million. In PPP loans. How much did Planned Parenthood get done?
Oh, I think close to 100 of them.
I think it was 80 million.
Yeah,
80 million.
Well, I was going to say close to 100 million.
And strip clubs got 11 million. A bunch of strip clubs got 11 million. That's A-okay. But the American Family Association got 1.3 million.
Ooh. That's right. And that's, you know, that's Governor Newsom's dinner tab. laundry.
Governor Newsom, I'm so glad you brought him up, because I'll tell you, hardly knows where to go. This is such a target-rich environment. But the way they found this out is, this is our old friends, the Southern Poverty Law Center. We are the 14 groups designated by the Southern Poverty Law Center as hate groups.
Which Dr. Morse, essentially means if you disagree with them on certain issues, they won't debate you.
Right.
They won't tell you where they think you're wrong. They won't attempt to engage in a dialogue. They simply say you're a hate group. You disagree with us on same-sex marriage, for instance. You're a hate group. If you say that there's no science behind transgenderism, you're a hate group.
Right. 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 So that's how we got on this group, how we got on this list. Some of our dear friends got on this list in the same way. The American College of Pediatricians, whom we have featured many times in our programs. This is a group of pediatricians who are saying the science is not there for giving cross-sex hormones to children. I mean, a group of pediatricians is a hate group. That's how these people think. And by the way, some of our longtime followers will remember that in 2017, we had our credit card processor cut off summarily, just like that, overnight. Well, not overnight, like within 5 minutes of receiving an email, we went to our credit card, our online store, our online donation processor, and found out we no longer had credit card services because they had cut us off. The company had cut us off based upon the work of the Southern Poverty Law Center. And that's the same organization that NBC News is using to say, isn't it shocking that these 14 groups have received $4 million of paycheck protection money? So that, well, that was their opening salvo on December 9th. Then on December 12th, they went even further and said, anti-gay nonprofits and businesses received millions in COVID-19 aid. And in this one, they went beyond the 14 groups and went to other organizations that that they consider hateful, that they consider having an established record of anti-LGBT activism, and called them out for why did the terrible Trump administration allow these people to get money. You remember that, Don?
I certainly do. You know, by the way, Dr. Morse, to be consistent, I think the Southern Poverty Law Center and NBC would have to say the Catholic Church is a hate group. They'd have to say the LDS Church is a hate group. They'd have to say that Hasidic Jewish congregations are hate groups. Because as you pointed out, this is traditional morality. You could call it Christian morality. You could call it biblical morality, but it's the basis of Western civilization.
That's right. That's right. And as a matter of fact, you know, if we look at how Governor Cuomo has behaved and de Blasio, how they have behaved towards the Orthodox community in New York City, they've been horrible to the Orthodox Jewish community in New York. Don't you think, Don?
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, it's interesting. Cuomo decided he was going to ban large groups of Orthodox Jews, Hasidic Jews, from attending funerals based on a picture he saw of a Hasidic funeral from 3 years earlier.
Wow. Wow. And fortunately, not, I don't know which particular, it wasn't even a congregation. There was a Jewish relief organization in New York City, which together with the Catholic Diocese of Brooklyn sued and won and said, you guys are, these rules are singling out religious people unfairly.
Right.
Yeah. So, and that was very good that they did that. But in the meantime, let's get back to NBC News and what they're doing. I think, Don, I think that they are trying to set up a situation where come a Joe Biden administration, which they're all counting on, that one of their moves is going to be to say, the Paycheck Protection Program, yes, it's forgivable loans, but you guys, because you're a hate group and because we don't like you very much, you're going to have to pay back those loans. I think that's where they're going with this. I think they're softening up the public to change the rules midstream and say that you didn't really qualify. Now you have to pay it back.
I wouldn't be at all surprised. You know, for the Southern Poverty Law Center and for NBC, hate pays.
That's right.
They're making money off of hate by exposing these alleged hate groups. So I guess now they're going to make us pay.
Right.
Pay the money back. You know, even though there are all kinds of nonprofit organizations that have received money from the Paycheck Protection Program,
yeah,
so they wouldn't go out of business. But you know, Dr. Morse, while they're worried about us repaying the money, one of the co-authors of an earlier piece also did something that, in a way, defending Pornhub.
I know that was so weird, huh?
The
Tell
country's
people about
leading,
that.
Yeah, the country's leading distributor pornography on. Let me see if I can get the date. December 15th. One of their writers, Olivia Salon, who written one of the earlier hit pieces on us, ran an article titled "Pornhub Crackdown by Credit Card Companies Cuts Off Sex Workers' Livelihood."
Oh,
so, I know. You gotta feel for those poor sex workers.
Yeah, it says here, thousands of people have turned to this type of online sex work to feed their families. And this move is affecting those moms who just want to buy diapers and milk by uploading pornography of themselves.
I'm sorry. You know, I shouldn't laugh at this, Dr. Morse.
I know. So let's give people some background, okay? Because not everybody follows this as closely as we do. You know, sometimes, Don, I think we're a little, I don't know, this is like we're looking into the abyss all the time. So anyway, followers, people watching, we read this stuff so you don't have to. But anyway, what happened was earlier in December, Nicholas Kristof over at the New York Times published a very big expose of Pornhub. Pornhub is a hub for consumer-produced pornography. So you could take naked pictures of yourself and put them up there. And in fact, we did an interview with somebody who once did that, our interview with Aaron Brewer. This is a woman who was a very top-rated performer on Pornhub, and she had a conversion experience and walked away from it, and so on and so forth. But anyway, this is what Pornhub is. You can upload porn of yourself and then make money from it, okay? So that you can monetize your little page. The problem is sometimes people are uploading porn, not of themselves, but of other people without their consent. And they're sometimes uploading child porn, and they're uploading rape videos, and they're uploading what is called revenge porn. Now, yep. Anybody familiar with revenge porn? That's when you break up with somebody and they have these pictures of you. And just to be mean to you, they take those naked pictures of you and put them up on the internet, and they can be up there forever. So anyway, Nicholas Kristof wrote this big expose about Pornhub and how much child pornography was actually up there. And as a result, I'm sure as a result of that, and who knows how long that story was in the making and what went on in the background, but very soon after that story, the major credit card companies all said, we're not going to process credit cards on Pornhub at all for anybody anymore. Okay. In the meantime, Pornhub scrambling around saying, oh, we've put all these safeguards in place. Oh, we're clean. Even though like a third of their content went away or something. I forget the exact amount. I think we have that in another story somewhere, don't we, Don? I think we put it. But anyway, this is the context. And most, normal, decent people are like, wow, it's really good that somebody's putting a stop to child pornography, to this large purveyor of child pornography. And when Pornhub comes up and says, oh, we put a stop to all the abuses, normal people are like, yeah, really, thanks. like you would have done that without the expose.
Right.
Yeah, tell me another. So anyway, Olivia Salon very nicely inquired of the sex workers who are losing their livelihoods. And these are some of the things that she said that she found a person. Oh, listen to this quote, Don. People, this is not for little kids, okay? But anyway, but you need to know. People, you need to know this is what's going on, okay? So here's a quote. Suspending Visa and MasterCard payments only prevents consensual adult sex workers from earning money on the site, end quote, said a California-based adult performer who goes by the name of Mary Moody. She said she has been making $1,000 to $2,000 per month selling videos as a high-ranking performer on Pornhub. In its statement, Pornhub described the credit card network's crackdown as, quote, exceptionally disappointing, because it came 2 days after the Adult Website Institute, quote, the most far-reaching safeguards in user-generated platform history. Like they would have done that without Nicholas Kristof breathing down their neck.
Oh, absolutely. And by the way, I don't think you can stress this enough. This is the New York Times that did the expose. I've never heard the New York Times described as a religious right group.
No.
Or, a group that's concerned about the sexual revolution. This is the New York Times, and they deserve credit for this. They're concerned about the fact that there are videos displaying the sexual exploitation of children and rape. And as you said, Dr. Morris, revenge porn videos. By the way, the fact that Olivia Salon would call these people sex workers is a giveaway. You know, that's the euphemism for porn stars
or prostitutes.
Or prostitutes, yes, yeah. Sex yeah. workers.
Right, right. And I think this is a good time to say to all of our followers that I'm sure those of you, you know, whatever your religious tradition is, if you're following the Ruth Institute, you probably believe, as Don and I do, that the human body is something sacred and that sexual activity is something sacred given to us by God for sacred and divine purposes, you know, and not as a toy, not as something to sell to make money from. You know, it's meant to be a total gift of self for the building up of the family, for the building up the community, and the propagation of the human race. You know, that's what sex is all about. It's sacred. And to talk about sex work is, as Don says, a giveaway that these are people who value something very different. They worship a very different God. They get mad at us and think we're theocrats or something, but they're theocrats. They're just worshiping a false God, you know, the God that says that your the pleasure of the body and the satisfaction of your impulses is the highest good. You know, that's not a neutral position, right?
But, you know, Dr. Morse, I think that this is something that you should discuss for the benefit of those watching this at home. The Ruth Institute does a lot of work to prevent sexual abuse, including the abuse of children. Yeah. I know you've mentioned grooming children. We work to help the victims of sexual violence and sexual exploitation heal. So while we're doing this, NBC is defending Pornhub, including child exploitation videos, and we're the ones who are hateful.
Right, right. And, you know, sometimes people will say, well, you know, obviously there's a difference between non-consensual sex with children and being sex positive. And I just want to say, I don't think that line holds. You know, in principle, that's true. Of course, it's true. But in fact, if you're creating a society where everybody thinks they're entitled to unlimited sexual activity and nothing bad is ever going to happen, if that's what you're propagating into people's minds, you won't be able to hold a hard and fast line between somebody with a lot of power taking advantage of people who are under their authority or something like that. You know, you won't be able to prevent the Weinstein situations and the Matt Lauer situations. If we could go back to NBC, you know, the poor girl who said that she had been assaulted multiple times by Matt Lauer, and finally Matt Lauer was let go by NBC. But it took them a long time to get around to doing that. The difference in power between the employer and the employee, between the megastar and the underling, between the bishop and a seminarian. You know, this is something we deal with at the Ruth Institute, that there have been in many, many, many instances within the Catholic Church, you know, where you're looking at a seminarian being groomed or sexually abused by, like, then Cardinal Theodore McCarrick. That's what he was doing. And the differences in the power, maybe it wasn't literally a crime. I get that it's not a crime, probably shouldn't be a crime, but is it wrong? Yeah, it's wrong. And you need to speak out about it and to tell people you shouldn't be doing this and to build up the victims so that the victims know it's not their fault, you know, so that people can identify grooming when they're being groomed. You know, that's the kind of thing that we do at the Ruth Institute. We're not a counseling organization, but we are a public information and educational organization. We're absolutely committed to helping people who have been bamboozled, you could say, by the sexual revolutionary ideology, to helping them to heal and to protect themselves further. You know, Don, you did some, as director of coalitions for the Ruth Institute, you did some legwork on this this NBC story, and you helped collaborate with one of our friends to put together a petition to NBC to just let them know that people are, that we're watching and that we're fed up with what they're doing. Tell people a little bit about that effort that you did, Don.
Certainly. Well, the Ruth Institute is partnering with Life Petitions, which is part of LifeSite News. We have a petition that's online now. People can sign it if they care to. And the petition demands that NBC stop smearing pro-family groups by calling them hateful, stop using the Southern Poverty Law Center as a source for this, and apologize for the harm they've done. So far, it's collected over 9,500 signatures. And I don't think we're through with it yet. So people are concerned about this. You know, news media lost so much credibility in the last campaign. There are very few people today, except for people on the hard left, who believe that the establishment news organizations are fair. They're not, and that's been documented. Media Research Center did a study of a two-month period during the 2020 campaign. They found that coverage of President Trump was 95% negative, whereas coverage of Vice President Biden was 67% positive. How do you get numbers like that if you're objective?
Right, right. Well, they've start from the conclusion and reason backwards. That's how they get there. That's sure. Their mindset. But you know, Don, there's something that one of these stories really troubled me about, and that's scapegoating. And this is something all of our followers need to be aware of, because if they're picking out a handful of little organizations like ours, like the American Family Association, and scapegoating us, where do you think you're going to come into the picture? You know, I mean, it's you and your values that they're after, right? So let me read you some of these quotes from this one article. I think this is the December 12th article. Anyway, it's the second one. It says, there's a whole section called warped priorities. Okay. And this is where they go into the scapegoating argument. Okay. Kyle Herrig, president of Government Watchdog Accountable US, said it's shameful. It's shameful that the Trump administration provided pandemic relief funds to organizations promoting bigotry, intolerance, and hate, with, quote, so many small businesses forced to shutter since the start of the pandemic. Okay, so in there, there's a hint there that if it weren't for us, those businesses wouldn't have had to shutter. Here he goes on. It's hard to find a clearer example of the Trump administration's warped priorities than allowing countless mom and pop shops to go under without proper relief while bailing out wealthy and well-connected anti-LGBTQ enterprises on Americans' dime.
I didn't know we were wealthy and well-connected.
Like the Southern Poverty Law Center is living in poverty. Like the Human Rights Campaign doesn't own a big building in downtown Washington, D.C. You know, what? What? But here's the point. Here's the point. What they're suggesting is that it's our fault that those mom and pop businesses went under.
That's right. It's not Governor Cuomo's fault.
Not
Governor Newsom's fault. It's our fault.
Not the Chinese Communist Party. None of them. It's the Ruth Institute getting money. And here's a particularly egregious thing. Among the people they cite in this article are people who have had high profile legal conflicts with the LGBTQ establishment. Arlene's Flowers is the florist in Washington State that has been the victim of lawfare for, I don't know, 10 years by now. I don't even remember how long, but this is the florist who said, look, you guys, I'll keep making flower arrangements for you, but no, I'm not going to do the flowers for your wedding. She thought they were her friends and they dragged her into court. Okay. And we're supposed to feel bad that Arlene Flowers got a little bit of money from the Paycheck Protection Program. We're supposed to feel bad about that. Okay. So, and Harris Funeral Homes, that was the party to the recent suit that ended up establishing, how do I want to put it? It was the transgender case, but you know, basically saying that, and it was decided the wrong way. But the point is, these companies which had the nerve to fight, which had the nerve to resist, that's who they're saying doesn't deserve any relief. See, this is scapegoating. This is propaganda. That's what people have to understand. And please sign our petition. You know, I think, Don, if I'm not mistaken, you wrote this petition. At the bottom of the petition, isn't there a place like an email where you could email NBC and tell them what you think?
Yes, there is. It's right. It's at the bottom of the petition. And, you know, I think you've given me too much credit. Really, you and I wrote the petition together. But that's, you know.
And our friends at LifeSite, and our friends at LifeSite did a lot.
Yes, our friends at LifeSite had a lot to do with the ultimate outcome of the petition.
Right.
You know, if you go to our website or our Facebook page. You can then get over to the petition. You can sign it, or you can simply go to Life Petitions, do a search. You can go there and you can sign the petition. And we have over 9,500 signers, most we've ever had on one of these petitions.
Right. And, you know, Don, that's because we're such a large, well-funded, wealthy organization that we can get
on. You forgot the well-connected, Dr. Morse. Oh, we're well-funded and we are well-connected.
Yes. Absolutely. Listen, folks, we're defending your values, you know, and we're out here and we're being yelled at and called names. And you know what? I don't care. If you think it's hateful to say that children need their own parents, then fine. I'm a hate group. Come get me. You know what I mean? That's the way I look at it. And the Ruth Institute intends to stay on the front line of this battle. We are not retreating. We are not going away. We have put our flag in the sand. And I hope that all of you will rally around it. Don, do you have any final words for our viewers?
No. Well, other than the word irony. And no. as a friend of mine once said, whatever the left accuses you of, they're guilty of themselves. NBC is guilty of most of the things they're accusing us of. Except we're not guilty. They are.
Yeah. All right. Thanks very much for watching, everyone. And we certainly do appreciate your support. And we wish you all a very happy new year.